35 years in power, President Paul Biya since 1982 on the 6th of November. Mr. Akko John, good evening.
Evening.
It's a pleasure having you. You're a political analyst and you're a university don.
Yeah, mine too.
Yes. Now, you are a university don and a political analyst, like I introduced you. 35 years in power today. What can you say of the new D government of President Paul Biya when you look at the successes, the challenges, and even the failures? Are there any?
Yeah, I will tell you that if they had brandished something as success, I believe the CPDM or the ruling party came to power in 1982 when there was a general wind of change blowing all over Africa for those who have been in power after a particular time, and Cameroon was not left behind. In fact, this was the time when the international community obliged member states of the United Nations to ratify a lot of the treaties, those relating to human rights, those relating to freedom of expression, freedom of organization, association, political parties. And this is what we realize today in Cameroon. And equally, the right to education, I believe this is what those who celebrate the 35 years now count as successes. But then, I will equally tell you that the same party that came in power in 1982, there was equally an intention or a mind that there is a state of rigor and moralization. But then we are embarrassed that 35 years later, if you get back to the honors of histories, you realize that within the 35 years, where this same party celebrated and took oath, we are talking of the Northwest region in Bamenda. Today, Bamenda is nowhere to be found. We don't even celebrate this history. The same thing we are celebrating today in other parts of the countries. In fact, there is nothing done in Bamenda.
Today, are we celebrating 35 years in power of President Paul Biya, or we are celebrating the CPDM? Who should be celebrating today?
In fact,
the CPDM party or President Paul Biya and his close collaborators?
This is what we are coming, that a few group of people have hijacked the resources. They have hijacked, I mean, the state is under hostage by a few who manipulate their interests and find their way out. And 35 years, I mean 35 years of uncontrolled corruption, 25 years of uncontrolled intimidation, political opponents, 35 years in prison, uncontrolled human rights abuses. In fact, the report card or the transcript for Cameroon is number one as the most, in fact, most poorest nation when we get to the HIPC initiative. These were things that were not there before 1982. Cameroon was nowhere to be found under most poorest nation. Cameroon was not the most corrupt country. Cameroon, human rights records, even though some reported, but I believe we live during the age of authoritarianism. I mean, some people have equally said we are celebrating 35 years of authoritarian regime right in Yaoundé.
I will say that the Minister for Communication, Isachiruma Bakari, says some of these reports have been cooked by the international organization.
He is one of the people that the negative figures we celebrate in this nation. And I will tell you that we are equally celebrating 35 years of lies telling by the government for unfulfilled promises made to their citizens. We find the same speech coming from the leaders of government telling the citizens, this is what we'll do, this is what we are going to do. But at the end of the day, you realize that nothing is done. 35 years after, get to some villages without roads, some villages not still connected to their political regional headquarters. It is still a problem. We still to find out whether 35 years will give Cameroonians the peace the people claim. Because I was embarrassed when I watched over one of the national medias, one of the political dons, whom they call the central committee member of the CBDM, telling you we are celebrating 35 years of territorial integrity, 35 years of peace, 35 years of solidarity. And I ask, if really these are virtues at the same hour this country should be celebrating, or we should be making propaganda about. You ask yourself, are we territorially stable? Are we, by social integrity, are Cameroonians peaceful at this very hour this year? I mean, they are having a problem because we are first of all celebrating 35 years without a political agenda, because we don't even know where we were, we don't even know where we are, and we don't even know where we are going to.
We have Vision 2035. We equally have the 3 years emergency program as far as economy is concerned. Are you saying that all these things are not enough to push Cameroon forward towards development and nation building?
One thing I have heard for 35 years of the regime in Yaoundé, I have realized that we do more of propaganda than carry out actions in the field. And this is what we are saying. When we look at the emergency plan, we were here before the year 2000, when China became an emerging economy, when China was evolving to become a political contender, an economic powerhouse in the world. It was not, in fact, it was not an issue of propaganda, but we saw realities that now in every household throughout the world, when we talk of China, we see China present in our houses, we see China present on our roads, we see China present in most investment opportunities throughout the world. We are not going to talk of a propaganda. 35 years emergency plan, 3 years emergency plan, we ask ourselves, why are there still some regions without roads? Why is there unemployment still uncontrolled? We still have the youths leaving school. In fact, I say when I see them at the mercy of heaven, because a Cameroonian youth does not even know if he represents public life in Cameroon. Decisions are made by people who are supposed to be on retirement. In fact, when you revise the laws of Cameroon, you realize that majority of those who own public offices are those whom we hope are supposed to be on retirement, but these are the same people occupying the position that were reserved for the youths. We are still to see a simple gesture from the leader of this party who is going to nominate or appoint an individual, a youth that will count and make others find a witch in their mind. I remember this saying, one child asked the father, Daddy, who is the Paul Biya of Nigeria? And you can imagine when a child asks a father, who is the Paul Biya of Nigeria, meaning the word Paul Biya has become a political position.
I must say he has been winning elections before.
Yet it is not winning.
Why remaining in power? He has been winning elections.
Yes, Hansen's elections.
He has not remained in power because he didn't win elections.
Hansen, you have right to your
opinion. Going by the Electoral Commission and the Supreme Court.
And you need to look at the composition of the Electoral Commission. You need to look at those who make up the Supreme Court of Cameroon. Who are they? When you are going for an election, with the referee of the election being appointed from the political party, with the members of the Elecam being the members of the ruling party, by the members of the territorial administration still appointed by the ruling party, that is not an election. Where a game is played with one-sided referees, then that is no longer a game. When the referees and the linesmen became players on the other opposite side, then I don't think we talk of a match. In every football match, the referee is said to be impartial and independent in his results. But when you have electoral system like the one we are having in Cameroon, I will tell you that if this is not even corrected, elections are just open propaganda to say or tell Cameroonians we are respecting democracy. This country is not in any way a democratic state, because people say democracy, human right, but I will tell you, your brothers, your friends,
you have freedom of speech. Now you are talking, you can talk here freely.
Yeah, we are talking, but I will tell you that many have said equally that the right to talk is a right, but the right after talking is what we don't know, and that is what exists where we are, and that is the context. Mm-hmm. I am telling you, we need to live as a people. We need to be sincere. We need to act like those who have the country around. When you carry investment, which were meant to serve citizens in Cameroon, when you carry money, which is meant to serve Cameroonians, and you put them in foreign banks, are you helping this nation? We need to censor a lot of those people, and you write, know that 35 years after, Cameroonians, what they were not doing before 35 years ago is what they are practicing now.
But at least seeing most of these persons in jail, that shows that the rigor, morality, and integrity that President Paul Biya preached in 1982, he's putting into action, arresting some of these people who have been embezzling money and putting in foreign accounts.
Yeah, when such people who are arrested are his political opponent, then there is a problem, because we still know a lot of those people with unaccounted funds are still littering the streets of Cameroon. Are they even the ones making propaganda on his behalf? And I will still tell you that most of those who carry out this action, it might be that our head of state has been doing a great job, but then his entourage too is a problem. Many encourage him to stay there because they know that where they are, if he has to leave, then the consequences will fall on them. Equally, we'll go after them. It doesn't sound anything for us to have a country we are governing and will keep on ruling it by propaganda. We need to see government actions in the field. If we say education for all, I will tell you, it's something people will tell before 1982 and even after, before 1990, I believe some of us went to school, and even though primary school education was not declared free, I will tell you, we went to school with little or no school fees. A child could pay 1,700 francs or 700 francs to be in primary school, or in secondary school, people paid 7,500 and 5,000. But you can imagine what is happening today in a country we are talking of, a successful educational system, where now the public schools that were reserved for the low class are now instead outline or sideline for the rich, because for you to get a child into any of this environment, it won't be very easy.
Yes, so President Paul Biya 2018, another 7 years to clock 42?
Will
you advise that?
I won't and I will never advise a president like us at this level to still participate into offices, because we still doubt. Normally a president has a working calendar. A president should be out of the country for equally a leave, a work leave, like any other citizen. But we have realized of recent that those who rule are not even within the presidential powers, but those who at times are the ones instructing the head of state to do what he likes. We are just looking at the various crises all over the country. We are still waiting to see the gesture of the head of state, one who is vibrant, one who is ready to act, to pass out as a father of the nation and talk to the people, to pass out as a father of the nation and give concrete solution to it, not to still continue at this level, act as a major messenger. At a particular age within the African community, we believe that there is a certain age we cannot act. And even by human mental calculation, at a particular age, your mental activity becomes very reduced. We need somebody who is active, who can take us to the next. In fact, 3.5 decades ago,
even though what they are saying has nothing to do with the health of the president.
Yeah, no, I'm not talking of the laws, even the administrative laws of this country, recognize that there's an age to work, and then there's an age for the same person to relax. And we just believe that when there is an age for you to relax, you need to take bed rest. And you can imagine what is happening with others. Some people, some time ago, were ready to take voluntary leave, and then they take their voluntary retirement, and they could live quietly, not that they were old, but then to take some time for themselves and occupy with other activities.
Right.
Our president can be a counselor for the next country. Our president can equally be a consultant for what concerns international diplomacy or the economics of the nation. Why not? You see what is going on in Nigeria.
Thank you.
You can realize that Obasanjo today has become a consultant and effort for the UN, for the African Union, and even to his country, Nigeria.
Thank you very much, Akko John. You are a university don and a political analyst. It was a pleasure having your views tonight.
The pleasure is mine. Anytime will be at your disposal.
It was equally a pleasure being with you.